Hello and welcome to my mythography. Today I will tell you about my personal favorite beings, vampires. Vampire is one of the most well-known creatures in the world. It has roots in Slavic mythology, and even though some form of vampire-like creatures could be found in every culture in the world, the word vampire or vampir is originally a Serbian word accepted worldwide. Vampires in Slavic mythology are ghosts or undead corpses brought back to life by an evil spirit or the devil himself. They are stuck in our world, unable to find their peace. The way someone turns into a vampire in Slavic mythology is quite different from the general belief. Similar to witches, it is said that if a dog, a cat, a bird or a bat would jump or fly over their dead body, there was a high chance for them to turn into a vampire. Also, if someone would step on their grave in the first 40 days of their death, the chances are high that they wouldn't stay dead. Belief that biting a person would turn them into a vampire has no grounds in Slavic mythology. Most likely people to become vampires are middle-aged men who are sinful, murderers, bandits, and evil, as well as those who perform some type of black magic during their life. Knowing this, people would take extra good care of their bodies, burying them deeper, facing downwards, and throw stones on top to stop them from turning. After the vampire awakens, he would get out of the grave each night, suffocating people and drinking their blood. At first, they would show themselves in the form of a shadow or even invisible, but after they start feeding, they would gain strength and transform. After the first 40 days, which are critical for a vampire, if he feeds on the blood frequently, he would get fatter and their skin would turn rosy. They could also take the form of an animal that crossed over their grave. While a victim of the vampire would fall sick and pale, wither or die. After a certain amount of time, vampire could even achieve something similar to the look he had while still a human. Vampires live close to their grave, usually cemetery. If strong enough, some of them won't even need to return to the grave with the first sunlight, but would instead wander around crossroads, water mills, or even their family homes, scaring people. Some are even known to reunite with their widows and make children. Children born out of a love relationship between a human and a vampire have the ability to see, find, and kill vampires. They have no shadow and less bones. No matter where they go, vampires never drift too far away from the grave, keeping a watch on it at all times, because if the grave gets destroyed, he would lose all of his power. People greatly feared vampires, as they were stronger and faster than them, and they could shapeshift. To destroy a vampire, first they would take a young and strong black horse to the cemetery, as they could sense where vampire lies. Once they dig up the grave and open the coffin, they would check if the body is well preserved. Vampire's teeth, hair, and nails keep growing even after death, and if their face looks full and lips red, then they would impale him with a stake through the chest and then burn the body. Those who kill the vampire should take extra good care not to get blood on them, as that could turn them into one as well. Preventive measures are always better though, and it is said that vampires are turned away by garlic and iron. To protect themselves, people would bury the potential vampires with their face down, cut the skin behind their knees, and stick thorns under their nails. Some of them would go as far as removing head and limbs from the body to make sure that the dead wouldn't return. Thank you for watching, and I hope you will join me in my next journey.